Winnie the Pooh by AA Milne. Story 1, in which we are introduced.
Here is Edward Bear now, coming downstairs on the back of his head, behind Christopher Robin.
It's the only way he knows of coming downstairs, but sometimes he feels that there really is another way. If only he could stop bumping for a moment and think of it. And then he feels that perhaps there isn't.
Anyhow, here he is at the bottom and ready to be introduced to you. Winnie the Pooh.
When I first heard his name, I said, just as you were going to say, but I thought he was a boy.
So did I.
Then you can't call him Winnie.
I don't.
But you said...
He's Winnie the Pooh. Don't you know what the means?
Ah, yes, now I do.
I hope you do too, because it's all the explanation you're going to get.
Sometimes Winnie the Pooh likes a game of some sort when he comes downstairs, and sometimes he likes to sit quietly in front of the fire and listen to a story. This evening...
What about a story?
What about a story?
Could you very sweetly tell Winnie the Pooh one?
I suppose we could. What sort of stories does he like?
About himself, because he's that sort of bear.
Oh, I see.
So could you, very sweetly?
We'll try.
Once upon a very long time ago now, about last Friday, Winnie the Pooh lived in a forest all by himself under the name of Sanders.
What does under the name mean?
It means he had a name over the door in gold letters and lived under it.
Winnie the Pooh wasn't quite sure.
Now I am.
Then we'll go on.
One day, when Pooh was out walking, he came to an open place in the middle of the forest. And in the middle of this place was a large oak tree, and from the top of this tree there came...
Winnie the Pooh sat down at the foot of the tree.
That buzzing noise means something. You don't get a buzzing noise like that, just buzzing and buzzing without it meaning something. If there's a buzzing noise, somebody's making a buzzing noise. And the only reason for making a buzzing noise that I know of is because you're a bee. And the only reason for being a bee that I know of is making honey. And the only reason for making honey is so as I can eat it.
So he began to climb the tree. He climbed.
And he climbed.
And he climbed.
And as he climbed, he sang a little song to himself.
Isn't it funny how a bear likes honey? Buzz, buzz, buzz. I wonder why he does.
Then he climbed a little further.
And a little further.
And then just a little further. By that time, he had thought of another song. He was rather tired by now, so it came out as a complaining song.
It's a very funny thought that if bears were bees, they'd build their nest at the bottom of trees. And that being so, if the bees were bears, we wouldn't have to climb up all these stairs.
He was nearly there by now.
If I... just stand on that branch. Oh, help! If only I hadn't... see, what I meant to do... Of course, it was rather... it all comes, I suppose, of liking honey so much. Oh, help! Oh, ow!
He crawled out of the gorse bush, brushed the prickles from his nose and began to think again. And the first person he thought of was Christopher Robin.
Was that me?
That was you.
Christopher Robin said nothing. But his eyes got larger and larger, and his face got pinker and pinker.
I'd better go to see Christopher Robin,
said Pooh.
Christopher Robin lived behind a green door in another part of the forest.
Good morning, Winnie the Pooh.
I wonder if you've got such a thing as a balloon about you.
A balloon?
Yes. I just said to myself as I came along, I wonder if Christopher Robin has such a thing as a balloon about him. I just said it to myself, thinking of balloons and wondering.
What do you want a balloon for?
Honey.
But you don't get honey with balloons.
I do.
Well, it just so happened that you had been to a party the day before at the house of your friend Piglet. And Piglet had balloons at the party. You had had a big green balloon, and one of Rabbit's relations had had a big blue balloon, and had left it behind, being really too young to go to a party at all. And so you had brought the green one and the blue one home with you.
Which one would you like?
It's like this. When you go after honey with a balloon, the great thing is not to let the bees know that you're coming. Now, if you have a green balloon, they might think you are only part of the tree and not notice you. If you have a blue balloon, they might think you're only part of the sky and not notice you. And the question is, which is most likely?
Wouldn't they notice you under the balloon?
Well, they might, or they might not. You can never tell with bees. I shall try to look like a small black cloud. That will deceive them.
Then you'd better have the blue balloon.
You both went out with the blue balloon, and you took your gun with you, Christopher Robin, just in case, as you always did. And Winnie the Pooh went to a very muddy place that he knew of, and rolled and rolled until he was black all over. And then, when the balloon was blown up as big as big, and you and Pooh were both holding onto the string, you let go suddenly, and Pooh Bear floated gracefully up into the sky and stayed there, level with the top of the tree and about 20 feet away from it.
Hooray!
Isn't that fine? What do I look like?
You look like a bear holding onto a balloon.
Not like a small black cloud in a blue sky?
Not very much.
Oh, well, perhaps from up here it looks different. And as I say, you can never tell with bees.
There was no wind to blow him nearer to the tree, so there he stayed. He could see the honey, he could smell the honey, but he couldn't quite reach the honey.
Christopher Robin!
Hello?
I think the bees suspect something.
What sort of something?
I don't know, but something tells me they're suspicious.
Perhaps they think you're after their honey.
It may be that. You can never tell with bees. Christopher Robin?
Yes?
Have you an umbrella in your house?
I think so.
I wish you would bring it out here and walk up and down with it and look up at me every now and then and say, "Tut, tut, it looks like rain." I think if you did that, it would help the deception which we are practicing on these bees.
Well, you laughed to yourself.
Silly old bear.
But you didn't say it aloud because you were so fond of him and you went home for your umbrella.
Oh, there you are. I was beginning to get anxious. I have discovered that the bees are now definitely suspicious.
Shall I put my umbrella up?
Yes, but wait a moment. We must be practical. The important bee to deceive is the queen bee. Can you see which is the queen bee from down there?
No.
Pity. Well, now, if you walk up and down with your umbrella, saying, "Tut, tut, it looks like rain," I shall do what I can by singing a little cloud song, such as a cloud might sing. Go!
Tut, tut, it looks like rain. Tut, tut, it looks like rain. Tut, tut, it looks like rain.
How sweet to be a cloud floating in the blue. Every little cloud always sings aloud. How sweet to be a cloud floating in the blue. It makes him very proud to be a little cloud. Christopher! Ow! Robin?
Yes?
I have just been thinking, and I have come to a very important decision. Ow! These are the wrong sort of bees.
Are they?
Quite the wrong sort. Ow! So I should think they would make the wrong sort of honey, shouldn't you?
Would they?
Yes, that's what I think. Ow! I shall come down.
How?
I hadn't thought of that.
No?
If I let go of the string, No, I don't like the idea of that.
No.
On the other hand...
Yes?
No.
Oh.
Christopher Robin, you must shoot the balloon with your gun. Ow! Have you got your gun?
Of course I have. But if I do that, it'll spoil the balloon.
Yeah, but if you don't, I shall have to let go, and that would spoil me.
I see. Well, then.
Ow!
Did I miss?
You didn't exactly miss, but you missed the balloon.
I'm so sorry. I'll try again.
But...
And Winnie the Pooh floated down to the ground. But his arms were so stiff from holding onto the string of the balloon all that time that they stayed up in the air for more than a week. And whenever a fly came and settled on his nose, he had to blow it off.
Pooh!
And I think, but I'm not sure, that that is why he was always called Pooh.
Is that the end of the story?
That's the end of that one. There are others.
About Pooh and me?
And Piglet and Rabbit and all of you. Don't you remember?
I do remember. And then when I try to remember, I forget.
That day when Pooh and Piglet tried to catch the heffalump.
They didn't catch it, did they?
I'm not saying.
Pooh couldn't, because he hasn't any brain. Did I catch it?
Well, that comes into the story.
I do remember, only Pooh does it very well, so that's why he likes having it told to him again. Because then it's a real story, and not just a remembering.
That's just how I feel.
Christopher Robin gave a deep sigh, picked his bear up by the leg and walked off to the door, trailing Pooh behind him. At the door, he turned and said...
Coming to see me have my bath?
I might.
It didn't hurt him when I shot him, did it?
Not a bit.
He nodded and went out. And in a moment I heard Winnie the Pooh going up the stairs behind him.
Story 2, in which Pooh goes visiting and gets into a tight place.
Edward Bear, known to his friends as Winnie.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.